driver's title, but going back through the years, say back to 1982, when it was called the World Endurance Championship, Jackie Hicks driving for Porsche scored his championship there also in 1983 also. In 1984, a gifted young driver named Stefan Bella won for Porsche, and he was the World Endurance Champion in 1984. In 1985, the duo of Derek Bell and Hans Stuck were winners for Rock Porsche. In 1986, Derek Bell. Once again, we are now less than 30 minutes away from the start of this race. It is exactly 10:37, and we are witnessing right now a thing we see in Formula One also as the pit lane is open. And taken his position on the grid. He will be starting in the second row, right behind the saddle Mercedes. Of course, it will be a rolling start. It won't be a stop start to do it in Formula One. It will be a rolling start. So now we see that Martin Brundle is getting out of the Jaguar. Now we also know one of the Nissan. The game is closed. We now see that the number one Mercedes-Benz is taking his place in full position. Number one, Mercedes-Benz being shared this weekend by Jean-Louis Schlesser and Mauro Baldi. So the front row is on the grid. Now the number one Mercedes, the silver car, and the red, white, and blue Nissan, car number 23. So the Mark Blondel starting the race now have the first three rows in position. I can't, from my position here, I can't see if the Peugeot has pulled into its spot. But once again, this is a very, very important day for the Peugeot Talbot Sport Team. This is their debut in the World Sports Prototype Championship. There are a lot of journalists in town from France and all across Europe who are following this story, and certainly it would be quite a story if the Peugeot would finish the race, and imagine if it would win. It would be quite the celebration. But right now, as I look down on the grid, I can see the number one Mercedes-Benz. They replaced the nose cone and the rear bodywork, but the tire warmers, those electric blankets, are still on. The number 23 Peugeot Talbot Sport Team has Kike Rossel and Jean-Pierre Jaboy. This car is making its official debut in the World Sports Prototype Championship here in Montreal. It is powered by a 3.5-liter non-turbo V10 running on Michelin tires. They're putting on their fireproof balaclavas and then strapping the helmets. And of course, they have to be strapped into these cars very, very, very securely also. The G-forces these drivers encounter, up to 3 Gs, 3 times the force of gravity, so that means that it's your neck. It feels like your head weighs 3 times as much, of course, and it's certainly a very, very grueling race for these drivers. Even though there is a driver change expected for all those teams running with 2 drivers, there are some cars entered in this race today with only 1 driver aboard to do the entire 110 laps. So we wish them luck. So now we can see that as the teams slowly clear the grid, the drivers are left alone in the cars as they prepare for this 110 lap race. The pace car has pulled into the pit lane as the cars come around.
Alors il faut surveiller le drapeau vert, le préposé au départ, va l'agiter si l'ordre est bon et s'il juge que le départ doit être donné.
So here we are on lap one, and the number one Mercedes has maintained his pole advantage by leading. The number 3 Jaguar is tucked in behind him. Bit of a gap back to the third place car, the number 23 Nissan. And now the Jaguar right on the tail of the number 1 Mercedes.
La lutte est engagée de façon très sérieuse, très sévère, entre la Mercedes et la Jaguar. Donc, la Sauber et la Simcoe. On se talonne.
Thank you. circuit as the cars slow down behind it. And I think Martin Brundle certainly will have to relax for a while now after his stormy start as he keeps charging past Mercedes-Benz. Now we have
thank you. passe la Mercedes.